Imagine an AMD graphics on a smartphone, but look no further because Samsung is about to flip that switch. Welcome back guys, TechMayo here, and if you have not subscribed, please hit on the subscribe button which is down below, and also click on that notification bell so you get notified anytime I post content like this, and it goes a long way to help the channel. If Samsung successfully pulls this off, it's going to be a huge win for Samsung, because at the moment the mobile industry is a lot more competitive than the way it used to be, say 2016 or 2015, or even down to 2017. Samsung and iPhone were dominating the smartphone market then, but now we have a lot more other smartphone industry coming up and really hitting it hard. So this is going to be a huge win for Samsung if they successfully do this for their flagship device. So from next year 2021, Samsung will hopefully infuse the AMD Exynos 1000 into their flagship device. Another exciting news is the CPU, which is said to be the ARM X1 Supercore CPU. The X20 series featured the Exynos 990 with custom cores, which is a lot more slower than the Snapdragon 865. So I think they're about to step things up since they had a little flop with the S20 series. It's not really that noticeable, but in the mobile industry, compared to the chip they could have used. So from the upcoming S20, we should be seeing a power upgrade compared to what we had on the S20 and the S20 Ultra. So in real sense, the X1 Supercore is a lot more faster in terms of performance and machine learning compared to the ARM 7-8 large core. So we're hoping it will make its way into the Samsung flagship device by 2021. Hopefully they will give us something, they will tease us with something with the X1 ARM core, which is going to be powerful if they successfully do this. Now, for the layman who is just there to spend his money and wants to buy a phone, if the ARM X1 makes it into Samsung devices, we'll be looking at a very powerful and a phone that would interact with you way better. I know a lot of people would not agree that their phones learn their day-to-day activity, that your phone learns to adjust to what you do every day. It learns to kind of work with you. If the ARM X1 makes it into Samsung device, we have more powerful machine learning on our devices. So all in real sense, the standard chip for Samsung device as a flagship device for 2021 will feature the ARM X1 super large core. And also, a few of them might feature the ARM A78 large core. With the new Snapdragon 875 chip in the works, every flagship phone of next year will have a huge power upgrade compared to what we're having this year. 2018 and 2019 was all about camera upgrade. And from the end of this year, 2020, to next year, 2021, will be all about power, who has the better chipset. Samsung is also testing another chip, the Exynos 992. Which is a 5 nanometer chipset, and this chip is expected to be inside the Galaxy Note 20 coming up in August, and the mass production of this same chip, that's the Exynos 992, is set to begin in August. So it's in line with the speculated or expected date of the release of the Samsung Note 20. The good thing about the Exynos 992 is that it is paired with the ARM Mali G78 GPU that was newly released. Pairing the ARM Mali G78 with the Exynos 992 will mean a better performance in terms of processing power and speed, better than the Exynos 990 and the Mali G77 found in the Galaxy S20 series. We will be seeing a 10% increase in performance and also a 15% increase in AI learning and game performance as well. And this is going to save more battery than ever on any Samsung device. If you need to learn more about the ARM Mali G78 GPU, I'll leave a link in the description box below. So a short summary of all we've said so far. The Galaxy S21 or the 2021 series of the Galaxy flagship device would launch with the AMD Radeon Graphics, and the upcoming Note 20 would launch with the Exynos 992 chipset paired with the ARM A78 GPU with 120Hz refresh rate. And if Samsung does this, it will help them stay ahead of the game and also be able to compete with whatever Apple is releasing this year, that's the iPhone 12. There's still a lot of designs of the Galaxy Note 20 flying around, but one we can trust is from OnLeaks. The device might feature a bigger camera lens with camera housing protruding out of the body like what we have on the S20 Ultra. And you will need a case for this device if you want to lay it flat on the ground, because it will keep doing this this thing phones do, like when you place it on the ground, it does this wobble, it wobbles around. So you have to use a case. Though at first, with the case, the phone might be heavy, but we all know with time, you get used to the weight of your phone. I won't go too deep into the design of what to expect on the Note 20, but so far we've seen promising leaks that we hope they look like that. And somewhere inside my mind, I really hope they don't look like most of what I've seen online. let's keep our fingers crossed that hopefully whatever Samsung releases will be better than most designs we've seen online. So there you have it, guys. What are your thoughts on Samsung featuring the AMD GPU and graphics? Do you like it, or would you expect to see a better GPU? Let me know in the comment section below. If you have not subscribed yet, join the family by clicking the subscribe button down below and also hit on that like button and also on that small notification bell so you get notified whenever I post content like this one. Guys, I will see you in the next one.